so here's the basic lockpicking maneuver that Matt showed, which is if I get grabbed, then first I go like this, and then I turn in, and I can do a strike to the face or so, but step through and take him to the ground, and lock up here, hold the arm, turn him over, you know, do all that fun stuff, lock the arm like this, press down. All kinds of fun ways to cause our friends pain. So if I do this in Rowan here, then yeah, rotate in and press this down, step through, yeah, there you go. And make sure you keep good pressure on the elbow to like push me down. Right? Yeah, there we go. You're doing a lot to support my weight, which you don't want to do. You want to, like, even though I'm doing it gently, I'm trying to actually press you down. Right? So here are some interesting variations that we were thinking of. So we've got the cross. If you get grabbed cross-handed, you don't even need to break this. You can just cup his hand here and press in like this. And then from here, you have a nice break from here. Or again, you can turn him over, etc. Let's see. What I find interesting though is stuff with weapons. So if I have a weapon, then I have all kinds of interesting options. So from here, if I get grabbed on the same side, right? I can go like this and press through like that. And I've actually got his arm trapped here. Let's see. If I get grabbed again, right? So I can even go like this, and if I go like this, he's gonna let go, but I can press in like this, and then from here, I've got a stab into his neck. I don't know if you can see. Cross hand grab, I've got fun things too. This one, right? Is a way of, it doesn't throw him directly down, but one of the fun ones is to go like this. And then like that, if you want to be particularly vicious, let's see, if I go like this, there are fun ones to do from here. So again, if I get grabbed, right, so yeah, like that, then I can go like this, and press this in like that, for getting cross-handed, right, get grabbed like this. This is the one that I like the most, like that, and like this, and then etc. Let's grab the other mesher real quick. So, in mesher, it's kind of common to grapple with the offhand in certain circumstances. So if we go like this, and he reaches across to grab my hand, then what I can do is press across like this, and into his elbow like that, and it'll force him down. Or, we go like this. So we cut like this, I go into reach like this, he can hook like that, and press down and across, and there we go, and yeah, from here, you want to press down with this and drive into the ground. Yeah. This is a sharp edge, I'm going to be a bit more compliant, but for the sake of showing the effectiveness of just the takedown, you can see that there's all kinds of fun stuff to do with this general formula of realistically, it just comes down to, he makes a link, right, on your arm, and all you do is, instead of going to the outside, which sometimes you can do, you don't even really have to, like, break his hold, but I can, right, and then from here, most people are going to not be comfortable with this, just press on the inside of the elbow, and once I have this, trying to do it slowly on this floor is, mostly was throwing me off balance, so if I do it a little quicker, right, like this, go like this, and then, right, try not to hit him in the face too much. So, here's one of my favorite variations. It actually is in the manuals, the medieval manuals. So, the idea is, I'm stabbing like this, and he catches my hand, and what I do is I drop the point down, begin working on this, the inside of the elbow here, and then Even though his hand is let go, it's caught on the dagger. And then from here, I begin to turn him over more. And then I can step in. And from here, realistically, the point of my dagger is lined up with the back of his head. So just kind of a tap and